Welcome back, students. Let's see another topic, that is animal kingdom. So we'll have a first look over the general characteristics of the animal kingdom. Most complex of all the kingdoms. So animal kingdom is mostly having many types of animals, so it is said to be most complex. Next, it involves multicellular, that means the organisms which are made up of many cells. They obtain food from outside sources. Okay, they move from place to get food. That means they can move from one place to another. They swallow their food and digest food inside the body. Next, basically there are two main types of animals, or you can say in the categories in the animal kingdom. First is invertebrates. That means an animal that does not have a backbone, and vertebrates, an animal that has a backbone. Now there are phylas, 9 phyla in the animal kingdom. First is porifera, second is coelenterata, flatworms, roundworms, segmented worms, mollusca, echinoderm, arthropod, and chordata. So these are some of the phylums. So let's start with the first, that is mollusk. Now these animals have hard shells surrounding the soft body parts. Example can be these shells found in the sea. They live in the water and damp places. Example for this is the snail and the sea scallop. Only a few do not have shells, like octopus and sea slug. Next category is echinoderms, which means the spiny skin. The starfish is an example for this. It has star shaped and also spiny. Next category is chordata, in which mainly the vertebrates are involved. They have internal skeleton, that means vertebral column is present, as well as they also have limbs. Example of this are fish, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and the mammals. So students, in this session we have seen that animal kingdom are basically is a complex of all the kingdoms. It involves all multicellular animals, which obtain their food from outside sources. They can move from one place to another, and they swallow as well as they digest their food inside the body. They are basically two, invertebrates and vertebrates. They are 9 phyla, porifera, coelenterata, flatworms, roundworms, segmented worms, mollusk, echinoderm, arthropod, and chordata. So in this we have seen mollusk. This we have seen mollusk, which have hard shell. Echinoderms, which are having spiny skin, and they are star shaped. Example for this is the starfish. Next is the arthropod. Arthropod, which makes up the 75% of the animal kingdom, and the basic categories of arthropod is that they have hard external skeleton, segmented bodies, and they have jointed legs. Example for this is the beetle, millie, centipede, or spider, or the crab. Next are the chordata, which basically involves the vertebrates. They have internal skeleton, they have vertebral column, as well as they have limbs. Example for this can be the amphibians, reptiles, and mammals. So students, in this session we have seen the classification of animal kingdom. In further session we will have a look over, more detailed look over the animal kingdom. Thank you.